Austin Matthews not in the lineup. Willie Nylander not in the lineup. Nick Foligno still going through quarantine. So the Leafs have got some roster changes, and it starts with Tavares playing between Galchenyuk and Marner. By the Jets with a pass in front of the net off the stick of Paul Stastny. Back of the goal now, Ehlers trying to come out in front, and it's knocked away there by Campbell. Jets get it out, and they'll come to center ice. No score early in the game with 3 minutes played. Now a loose puck in front of the Leaf goal and knocked away as Campbell had to make a save. Punch to the line by Tavares. Over the boards to join Marner and Tavares. A pass in for Marner. Marner to Tavares. He's in a goal! And a big save made there by Hellebuck with the blocking glove. Wing tries to play it back into the slot. That's bunted out at center ice. And the Leafs are back in action. And here's Marner to Tavares. Back for Marner. In front of the net, Galchenyuk hit the goal post in behind Hellebuck. The Leafs, this line has had two great chances.
This may have gone in. Look at the big screen. Galchenyuk gets it in the slot.
Yes, it is. Old Eagle Eye Ralph was right on the play.
Nobody has seen more of those go in than me. It just, there was such a delay with it coming out. Like you said, either it hit the post flat, but this was like a rocket off the mesh in behind the blocker of Connor Hellebuck. It was the second great chance this line had. Tavares had a great one earlier. Here's the call.
It's determined the puck entered the Winnipeg net at 16:19. We have a goal for Toronto.
My mistake. I told him it was 16:18.
Stastny back at center ice now for Winnipeg. Caught trying to get it into the slot area. Down is Campbell. The scramble is on. He dives out and covers up on it. And the soup is on here tonight.
Only two shots on goal for the Leafs, one of them finding the back of the net.
Marner to the left wing side for Brody. Brody looking to make a pass, goes around back of the goal. Marner's gotten tangled up there with Appleton. Going to be a penalty here to Winnipeg, and the shot is knocked away by Hellebuck. And here is the penalty coming. Down low, Spezza tries to center. That didn't work. Spezza gets it again. Works back to the top of the circle. Right side and a one-timer by Galchenyuk off the side of the goal. Referee signaled no goal, but he did that a little while earlier, too. Winnipeg to the power play, and they win the draw. Pionk off on the left-wing side, and a wrist shot scores! Right off the hop. A shot by Nikolai Ehlers gets past the glove hand of Campbell. And where the Leafs cannot score with a minute 11 on a 5-on-3, Winnipeg takes very little time to tie the score.
Two big differences. The Leafs lost every faceoff in the power play in the Winnipeg zone. Winnipeg wins the draw clean off Jason Spezza.
Ehlers with his 19th of the season to tie the game at once. Played along the boards and punched out as Muzzin got trapped. Here's a pass in on the left wing, going in, a goalie score! A shot by Kyle Connor, set up by Scheifele. And the Jets have scored quickly here, back-to-back, and it is 2-1.
This is exactly what the Leafs did the last time the Jets were in town when Winnipeg took 5 out of 6 points. Odd man rushes as Jake Muzzin, for some reason, decides that a puck that's about waist high coming around the boards pinches down.
And Scheifele. And now here's a loose puck and a break now for Scheifele. He's in alone on a breakaway, going in on goal, scores! Mark Scheifele broke out of the Winnipeg zone and beat the defense and beats Campbell. And this game has gone into a bit of a tailspin. And it looks like Michael Hutchinson is getting his equipment on and maybe coming into the game.
Well, this time it's Justin Hall that gets caught. It was Muzzin on the other side for the second goal. Now his partner returns a favor. This comes after Muzzin launched one about 15 feet wide.
Connor playing it back to the blue line for Forbert. He goes into the corner. Now back of the goal for Kyle Connor. Connor working it back to the point. Pionk's shot is caught. The left hand by David Rittich. Stastny's Second period brought to you by Molson Canadian. Get $4 18-ounce Molson Canadian for dine-in and domestic bottles at chucksroadhouse.com/takeout. Here's a chance for the Jets. Shifley and a good glove save made by goaltender David Riddick to come all the way out at center ice. And the Leafs are back in their own zone with Muzzin.
Let's not forget Willie Nylander as well.
And Austin Matthews. Yeah, there's a lot of the lineup. Not here. And a shot in front. They score! A perfect pass from Robertson in front of the net. And John Tavares is there to deposit it in behind Connor Hellebuck.
Robertson will pick up his first NHL assist. He dumps it to the corner, and Jason's a very innocent-looking play.
And Connor after it again. Connor trying to center. Shifley drops it back. Now a drive by Shifley, smothered by Riddick. They'll try the other side, courtesy Forbert. He gives it away to Mikheyev. Now to Hyman. Hyman to the left wing side to Muzzin with a shot. And a scramble there as the puck fell from the chest of Hellebuck, but quickly pounced upon.
Zach Hyman to get to the net.
Draw won by Toronto, but the puck goes all the way down into the Leafs zone. They score! A breakdown first by Marner, but then goaltender David Riddick wanted to just play the puck, and that was ill-advised. He missed it, and it's a real soft goal here, scored by Ehlers.
Mitch Marner, instead of turning to the boards when he got the puck back inside his own blue line, tried to turn to the middle. Ehlers poked it off his stick.
Riley to Marner. Marner with a pass down low. Hyman gives it back to him. Return to Hyman, trying to jam it in. And into the glove. It's grabbed by Hellebuck. But you like the idea of Zach Hyman stepping out from behind the goal line and trying to jam it in. It is Riley at center shooting it in. Stop back at the net by Hellebuck. Quickly played on. Leafs get to a loose puck and a shot, and down is Hellebuck to swallow that up and hold for a faceoff. To play it back for Muzzin. Long rink-wide pass for Spezza. That didn't work, and then Spezza passes it right onto the stick. A cop going in on goal, and a big save made there by Riddick. That was rather strange. Into his own zone. Now to Kerfoot. There goes Riddick to the bench. Robertson comes to center. He's in across the line with the shot. Good pad save made there by Hellebuck. Rebound in front of the goal. Galchenyuk couldn't get to it. Kerfoot is knocked down on the play. Forward on, but it is just equaling the manpower situation as they're shorthanded. Against the boards, grabbed off by the Jets. They shoot it at the empty net, and in it goes. Kyle Connor will put the finishing touches on this one with 36.1 seconds left. With an empty net goal to make it 5-2. Trying to turn and shoot there was Harkins. And as it's brought down the right wing side by Morrissey, centered in front, cleared by Mikheyev. There is the horn that ends the game. Some really serious breakdowns by first pinching and defense. Goaltending was shabby at times, and then really the huge goal was Marner losing the puck and David Riddick misplaying it.
Yeah,
otherwise, it's a one-goal hockey game, and they didn't score another goal, but at least it's there.
It's hard to break it down by what they didn't do as opposed to what they did. You know, what they did seemed to cost them. What they didn't do was take advantage of that power play in the first period, even the start of the third period. You're down a goal. You start with 2 minutes on the power play and get absolutely nothing for it. So from a Leafs standpoint, they've been better overall on the road this year, I think, and they're going to have to be with six games scheduled in a row.
Now you're going to have to check your local listings for the game Saturday. It is...
Not officially canceled, but...
But it is a situation with what's gone on with Vancouver. They're to play the first two games of this six-game road trip in Vancouver Saturday and Monday. But at this particular point, it looks like the game Friday night that Vancouver was supposed to play.
That's rescheduled.
That has been rescheduled.
Now, they could possibly go Sunday, Monday, gives Vancouver an extra day?
Could be, yeah. Who knows? We'll wait and hear from the National Hockey League and how that all sorts its way out. The Leafs will start to get some reinforcements back. Matthews should be back. Frederik Andersen is at least on the ice. That's a good sign.
Nylander.
Nylander should be back from quarantine. And the arrival of Nick Foligno and Ben Hutton will also be a part of the mix as well. So.